is going to have a go at spelling these words, and today all the words are going to be Australian animals. There could be a few insects in there too. So they're all, and they're mainly the Aboriginal words, so the original words for these animals that have come into the English language, or the Australian English language, as the name of these animals. So the first word is kangaroo. And there we go. My trusty assistant is having a go at spelling kangaroo. And hopefully we all know what a kangaroo is. Okay, so the second animal is a koala. In the tree, eating gum leaves, is a koala. Okay, the third word is goanna. Okay, a large lizard that likes climbing trees in Australia is called a goanna. Okay, the next word is platypus. This is a very, very unique Australian animal, and it's one that is a mammal and lays eggs and lives in the water, a little bit like a beaver. It's called a platypus. Okay, the next word is a galah, a large bird, parrot, that flies in Australia. There's a number of them. It's called a galah. And the next one is another bird, and another big large parrot is called a cockatoo. Yep, a cockatoo. There's different types of cockatoos, but that's one of them. Okay, so I'll put that that page to one side. And our next word is dingo. Australian movie, Lindy Chamberlain said, "A dingo took my baby." Dingo. Okay, the next word is a kookaburra. Yep, the a bird, sort of a kingfisher bird with a large beak that has a very unique laugh, is called a kookaburra. Okay, the next word is, or the next animal, is a dugong. These are a large sort of animal that swims in the ocean, eats seaweed, looks a bit like a sea cow. He's called a dugong. Okay, the next one, this should be an easy word, is an emu. Okay, a large flightless bird, like an ostrich, runs very fast, is called a emu. Okay, the next word is a quokka. These are from Western Australia, and they're a small sort of marsupial kind of thing that, yeah, don't really know much about them, but they're called a quokka. The next one, bandicoot. These are small sort of animals that like to dig holes in your garden looking for different things. They're called a bandicoot. Okay, let's put that page to one side. Okay, the next word is a wombat. Okay, a wombat, sort of animal with stumpy legs. It's a bit like a drum with legs, and lives in big holes in the ground. That's a wombat. And the next one is a yappy. These live in the water. also known as budgie, but a budgerigar is a small bird that's very popular in cages all around the world. Green, blue, yellow, those sort of colours. Okay, the next one. This one's a shark now, it's a wobbegong. Now a wobbegong is a type of carpet shark. Not dangerous, and I think they grow to about, a couple of metres, that's about it, and they're called a wobbegong. Okay, the next one is another type of parrot. This one's called a gangang. This is a gangang cockatoo. This is a gangang. They're a big black bird with a loud sort of screech, and they're called a gangang. The next one is a wallaby. Wallaby, very much like a kangaroo, but only smaller. So, and they're called a wallaby. Okay, another page. Next word is an echidna. These are also known as a spiny anteater, a bit like a porcupine, but these actually lay eggs. They're mammals and they lay eggs, and the eggs hatch to give their little babies, and they're called an echidna. The next animal is called a quoll. A spotted animal about the same size as a cat that likes to eat smaller, mice and that sort of things, and that's called a quoll. Now the next one is Rakala. Okay, a Rakala is the Aboriginal name for a water rat. So it's a rat that lives in the water. So the next one is a cassowary. So a cassowary, it's found up the north of Australia. It's a large flightless bird with a big beak, a bit smaller than an emu, lays eggs, and it's called a cassowary. The next one is another bird, and this one's called a currawong. It's a currawong, it's a large sort of black bird with a big beak. That likes eating chicken eggs. It's a currawong. The next one is a wallaroo. It's a wallaroo, it's like a small wallaby, and that's called a wallaroo. Okay, so the next one is a numbat. It's a bit like a wombat, but a lot smaller. The next one is a bilby. A bit like a bandicoot. Smaller than a rabbit. Very long nose. Likes to dig in the ground, probably for ants and those sort of things. And that's called a bilby. The next one's actually an insect. It's a moth, and it's called a bogong. Big sort of moth, about this big, browny grey colour, a bogong. Okay, here's the penultimate word, the second last word. It's a paddy. melon. So there we go, it's a paddy melon. It's a type of small wallaby, a small kangaroo. Very small. It's called a paddy melon. And the last word, the last animal, also a very small sort of wallaby or kangaroo sort of style of animal. It's called a potoroo. Bad.